So I actually saw some patients that hurt their eyes from observing the 2017 solar eclipse.
This is the coolest thing I've ever seen in my life.
I was lucky enough to have lived right in the pathway of totality. I saw the moment of totality pretty much just stepping out into my backyard. And all those people that hurt their eyes, they all made similar mistakes. So for this video, if you want to observe this year's solar eclipse happening on April 8th, I'm going to go over exactly the best and safest ways to observe it, and I'll kind of go over what mistakes they made. Let's focus in. First thing you want to do is get a pair of solar eclipse glasses and make sure that it's properly ISO rated for looking at the sun. Now, I want you to check the description of this video. I'll put some links and resources down there. There are some good organizations that have put together a list of companies and manufacturers and where you can get these glasses, knowing that they're properly made and actually safe to use when observing the solar eclipse. Now, when you get them, I want to make sure that you go over the instructions. They're usually on the inside arm of the glasses so you know how to properly use them. But right before you use them, make sure that you actually look at the lenses of the glasses. Make sure there aren't any scratches or holes in there. There might be little scratches and they'll just let in UV light and could actually damage your eyes. Now, one thing that you want to check is to make sure that it fits properly and stays on your face. And one thing that people forget is to check your children as well. Make sure that it's going to stay on their face. You might get caught up in the moment and sometimes forget that they're looking at the sun too, and theirs might fall off their face, or they might look at the sun and stare at it without even knowing. And so that's just one thing, just kind of be extra cautious and mindful of your children during the solar eclipse. The main safest way to use these is before you actually look at the eclipse, you want to be away from the sun, put them on, make sure that they're fit and they're staying on there, then look at the eclipse, and then when you're done looking at the eclipse, you turn away from the sun and take them off. That is the best and safest way. If you wear glasses, you want to put these over your glasses, not under. Now, the best time of the eclipse, if you are in the pathway of totality, you actually can take off your solar eclipse glasses only during the moment of totality, when the moon is completely over the sun and you're seeing the corona on the edges of the moon, then that's the moment that you can take off the glasses and just enjoy the moment. That's the best part of the eclipse, and it's safe not to wear them. Now, as soon as the moon goes further and the sun starts coming back out, then boom. Yeah, you want to turn away, put the solar eclipse glasses on, and then you can start looking at it. Some extra tips and don'ts. Don't think that you can use your normal sunglasses or multiple layers of sunglasses. You won't even get close to being safe like the solar eclipse glasses can do. And don't think for a second that you could maybe just look at the sun and chance it. Sometimes those little microseconds of constantly looking up at the sun can actually add up and add to damage to the eye. So don't even chance it at all. Also, don't wear these and then look through binoculars or telescopes or anything like that. That focused light can actually go and burn a hole in these glasses, and then the light will get to your eyes. And so that's one of the mistakes that a lot of people make, is that they will wear these and look through their telescopes or their binoculars thinking that they're safe, but doesn't really work out that way. And this brings me to my next point. If you do want to look through binoculars or telescopes, then you want to get one of these filters. These filters are actually made to go on the front of those lenses that you can actually put on the front of the lenses. And so then it actually filters out the light before it gets through your telescopes or your binoculars. And this is one of the common mistakes that I saw in 2017, is a lot of people that were wanting to line up their binoculars or telescopes or even their camera to take a picture, they weren't really wearing their sunglasses. They were maybe using their phone to block the sun to line up their camera, but every once in a while their phone would move down and then the light would get them in their eyes, and they do it again and again and again and again. After a while, yeah, it just kind of added up and started to hurt their eyes. So if I had one tip, just anytime that you're lining up something with the sun, going to look at the sun, just be careful and use the glasses correctly. Now, before we get to the next way we can observe the solar eclipse, the people that I saw in 2017 that kind of hurt their eyes luckily didn't have any severe long-lasting effects from it. And when we're talking about severe effects, we're talking about solar retinopathy, or in this specific case, sometimes it's called eclipse Blindness. And you can get this just from looking at the sun for a few seconds. And pretty much that focused light from the sun actually goes and gets focused to the delicate tissue in the back of the eye on the retina and actually burns that tissue and you go blind. Now what's tricky is the retina doesn't have any pain receptors, so in the moment, sometimes people don't even know that it's actually damaging or burning the retina. Sometimes those effects don't come until later, where you can have some pain and discomfort and irritation. In fact, sometimes the vision loss from solar retinopathy doesn't happen right away. In fact, it can happen hours later after the damage. And the vision symptoms can be maybe just a blurry spot right in the center of the vision or where the sun did the damage. Sometimes it can be just a black spot, completely blind in that spot, or distorted vision. Or sometimes you might notice that the color is a little bit different in that area, or maybe more different in one eye more than the other one. So if this happens to you, if you're having any of these symptoms, even if they're mild or subtle, definitely go into your local eye doctor and get everything checked out. And if you happen to glance at the solar eclipse, just make sure that you turn away from the sun as soon as you can. Give your eyes a break. A lot of times your retina cells will be bleached and you'll have that after image of the sun there. And just give your eyes a complete break and rest before you start looking again. So here are a few fun, safe ways to actually observe the solar eclipse. One of the most popular ones is a pinhole box. This is where you actually take a box and on one side you punch a little smooth pinhole and then point that at the sun. You don't have to look at the sun, you just point it at the sun and it projects the image on the other side, and that is where you can actually see the eclipse happening. Super fun for kids and a way to look at it without looking at the sun. Probably the coolest one that we did is you can take a colander or a strainer that has little tiny holes in there and put a little white sheet on the floor or on the side, and you actually point that at the sun and you'll have a bunch of little holes where, and you can see where the eclipse is happening. That was really fun to do. A lot of kids loved that one. Another recommendation is download an app. There are some apps that will give you time announcements of what to look for and what to observe for, and kind of countdowns. Made it really fun because sometimes they'll say, hey, look for shadow bands, and hey, start looking for changes in behavior with the animals, which did happen. It was really crazy. And so that's really fun. Make sure you download the app so then you can kind of know when to look and when to be safe and when to do this. And so made it easy. And if you're interested in that, I'll put some links to some different apps in the description below the like button. And then, yeah, make sure that you get some pictures, but make sure that you're doing it safely. Make sure that you're not accidentally looking at the sun trying to take a picture of the solar eclipse. But with taking pictures, just enjoy the moment. It's a very unique, almost life-changing experience that you might not ever experience again in your lifetime. The next one is 2033 if you happen to live in a section of Alaska, but after that it's 2044, so it's another 20 years. So if you can, if you live close, or if you can travel to the solar eclipse pathway, specifically if you can get into the moment of totality, that pathway, worth every time, money spent, definitely worth it, and I highly recommend it. Again, be safe, check out the links in the description, get those glasses as soon as possible, and I hope that you have as much fun as I did when I watched it. Stay focused.